Guys, welcome to 52 Drinks, 52 Weeks. We all know about Stranger and Sons, which has kicked off and become a part of the Gin Revolution as well. So we're not talking about that, but they have done something very peculiar, something very strange, and they have started doing their pickles and their cordials as a part of their cocktails, and the mad scientist behind that is Feruza. So, hello.
Hi.
Why would we even want to make cordials and pickles?
The pickling is actually a really interesting bit, because if you think about pickles and India, it's something that just fits.
And something that you can relate to as well. Every house has a grandmother or a mother,
exactly,
and a jar or a burny of pickle which is sitting in the sun for months before you can actually open and smell and taste it. But
it works.
How does it come into cocktails?
I mean, if you think about pickles and a cocktail, the first cocktail that usually comes to your mind is a Gibson.
Yeah.
And we wanted to do the Gibson, but better.
Okay.
And the way to make it better was to make an Indian.
So the classic guy didn't do well enough for quantity. Okay.
You know, he didn't cook for his time. Come on, I was like,
right,
100
years. But you wanted to make it Indian as well.
Yeah, because of course you're talking about an Indian gin and you're talking about pickles. So we wanted to make that one ingredient that we could control, the pickles. So we took ingredients from all over India, whatever was easily available, whatever was seasonal, whatever was even hard to get sometimes. And we put that into a cocktail and we created quite a lot of pickles. When you have one idea, it can expand into so many things.
So this one is apricot pickle. What other experiments have you made?
Well, some of our other pickles would be with fresh fruits like grapes, figs, and different types of cherry tomatoes. They can be fresh, fermented, sweet, sour, spicy.
Like
some. Okay,
calm,
yeah. There's a lot.
So rather than talking about it, why don't we show how our pickle is made?
Definitely.
So take over.
Basically, when you start off with a pickle, you need some very basic ingredients. You start off with your vinegar, sugar or salt, water, and basically work from there. And you can add spices to enhance flavor of whatever you're pickling. So the easiest way that we found is to basically make a little potpourri of your spices. That's bay leaf, mundu chilies, little coriander seeds, black pepper and star anise. Cinnamon. Okay, so we're just going to actually just break it a little bit. Okay, so you have some mace, which is your jawitri, and clove, which is lavang. And then you just put it on a muslin cloth, and we just tie it together. It doesn't have to be pretty, it's just a simple little potli that you have ready here.
And because we're making a sweet pickle, our primary ingredients is going to be sugar. We add a little bit of honey. So this is roughly 300 grams of sugar with 50 grams of honey, 500 grams of apple cider vinegar, and this is 10 grams of salt. I'm going to put it on a slightly high heat to dissolve everything, and once that's dissolved, we add our little spice potli bag. If you have scum on the top, like brown bubbles or spots, then you can just skim it out like this. You just add your little potli at this point. Now you can get your equipment ready. I prefer glass, and usually a rounded glass jar is better. So you basically start off with a dry jar, you sanitize it with hot water, vinegar, hot soap, whatever you like, and then we fill it up with our apricots. So this is 400 grams of dried apricots. So what you're gonna do, we still want our spices to continue to infuse. So I'm gonna put my little potli in here. So basically, once your brine has cooled down a bit, it should have no scum on the top. Now you're just gonna add it to your pickle. Do it gently and slowly. Now it goes right to the top. There's usually some brine left, but as time passes, the apricots start absorbing a little bit more, so the level will drop and you can just refill it again.
So guys, now that we made our pickle, we're going to let it rest for 3 days to 1 week. And what we're going to be left with are these. Once we bottle it in lovely little jars, it's ready to go. So we're going to start making our Indian spirited Gibson. And this particular one is known as the Pickler's Prescription. So what we're going to do, we're going to start off with 15 ml of the brine. So I'm making two portions out here. I'm going to put a touch of vermouth. That's going to be roughly 10 ml. And last but not the least, I have my stranger. Put some elevator music into this. Then what we're going to be adding is some very nice rice, just to quickly stir it. That's really good. So each drink is going to have one pickled apricot. And believe me, you should be eating it while you're sipping on it. Absolutely delicious. And there you have it. One pickler's prescription for you, one for me. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh yeah, this is super balanced. It's got the sweetness, it's got a little bit of tartness, that vinegary character is there. But yeah, even after all of this, where pickle is the hero as well, but the gin shines.
It definitely does.
It makes a pretty interesting drink, but more importantly, just balance, because you can then drink it more often. And you know, you think of pickle and becomes tart and it could be spicy and everything, but this is something which is more sessionable. You can drink it a little longer. So thanks a lot for this today. Thank you for teaching us pickling and showing us that it can work very well with cocktails. So grandmother drinking a cocktail while she's pickling, that's what it's going to be. The fun
thing. If your grandmother is drinking a cocktail while she's pickling, that pickle is going to be really good.
My grandmother is dead.